Hello everybody, Andrea Myaski here with Dentalelle Tutoring. I wanted to talk to you guys about kind of a subject that usually people don't talk about, but I feel that everybody should. And I did do a video on this before, but it's just kind of an update on it because I had a few students emailing me kind of asking them what to do. So what do you do if you're in school and you have a teacher or teachers that just don't seem to like you, or they seem to be marking you unfairly in clinic, or they're just making your days at school a lot harder? So whether that be they're just making their tests impossible or their exams impossible, you know, we have all had those teachers where you study for an exam, yet everything you study for isn't on the test and you wonder why. You know, it was that one little thing that they had mentioned 2 weeks ago that they base their whole test on, not your notes, not the textbook. So I don't know if you've ever had to deal with that, but I remember having to deal with that in school. Now I'm a tutor, so I'm a teacher per se too. So I don't understand when you have those teachers that give students a tough time, you know, teachers that are on a power trip and just want to make the students' lives difficult and miserable. Now, again, this isn't something, I probably don't sound very professional right now, but from teacher to student or, you know, friend to friend, whatever, I totally understand and just stick with it. Okay. And I say this because when I went to dental assisting, I had great teachers, great everything. When I went to dental hygiene, the first time, I took dental hygiene twice because my first program decided to shut down about 3 weeks before we were supposed to graduate. But the first time I had great teachers, they were wonderful. But the second time I took dental hygiene, there were two teachers, one in particular, that always just seemed to mark me unfairly in clinic. And I'm not just saying that because I'm sure every student will feel at some point that they were marked unfairly. But when I get one teacher telling me that I missed all of this calculus, and then another teacher telling me there's hardly any calculus there, what are you talking about? When I asked for a second opinion and to get help, it kind of makes you wonder a little bit, right? Like, how can one teacher find so much calculus when the next one finds a little bit here and there, but then she says to me, but you're a student, we can't expect you to be perfect. Kind of makes you wonder, right? So I had that one teacher in particular who just made my life hell, you know, for lack of a better word. I'm sorry, but school was very, very difficult for me. I didn't look forward to clinic because if I had her as my teacher that day, I knew I would fail my patient and have to find another one. So imagine feeling like that. Imagine knowing you're going to fail, even though you also know that you're not doing anything wrong. So this can go both ways. So whether you're in clinic or in your classroom, just having a difficult time with a teacher, it does happen. But I do have some tips for you, and this is what I did. Just think positive, okay? It's very, very difficult, trust me, but think as positive as you possibly can because school is not forever regardless, you have to get through it, right? If you simply just give up and say, this teacher doesn't like me, I don't want to deal with it anymore, never mind, that's not a good attitude because then that teacher's winning. Does that make sense? I feel that these teachers are on a power trip because they want to see students fail. I feel like they get some gratification seeing students have a tough time. If that makes any sense, it sounds horrible. So I really hope that that's not the case, but I can't imagine and I don't understand because as a tutor myself, I want all of my students to feel comfortable and feel comfortable asking me questions anytime. So I don't understand it. But as a student, just think positive, you guys, and kill your teachers with kindness, okay? You were probably wondering, what are you going to say there? Kill your teacher? No. Kill your teacher with kindness. Be nice and be as positive as possible, okay? Now, this could go both ways because some teachers may see your positivity and think, oh, okay, well, she's not taking this seriously. So I'm going to mark her even harder because that did happen to me. When I just tried to be my positive self, my happy self, that one teacher marked me harder. She was a lot harder on me than she already was. So I thought, you know what? I can't do anything right. It was the hardest thing ever. So I actually did the opposite of what I normally tell people. So what I did was I just simply acted like I wasn't happy. I wasn't smiling. I wasn't asking questions in clinic. I wasn't happy. I wasn't helpful. I just kind of sat there like, okay, just tell me what you want me to do and I'll do it, you know, and that's not me. So the teacher could see like, oh shoot, like I'm really, this girl's not happy. And then for whatever reason, she started to be nice to me and she started to let up. Weird, right? So it could go either way. So either be really, really happy and be your positive self, even though that's the last thing you feel like doing when your teacher is pretty much trying to fail you on everything. If that doesn't work, then totally shut down. So you have to do some acting a little bit here, okay? But just try that. And even me just simply saying that, I feel silly telling everybody, okay, well, either kill your teacher with kindness or just completely shut down and pretend that you're sad, pretend that you're as defeated as possible, and they might let up and leave you alone and move on to another student. It sounds bad, but then you can help that other student do the same thing if you see your teacher doing that. So I hope this helped. This isn't a very professional video of me, but I speak the truth. I'm honest. For my students, they all know that, and they know that they can ask me anything because I was a student for a long time, you guys. I was a dental receptionist first, and then a dental assistant, and then a dental hygienist. I took the dental hygiene program twice, and then I became a restorative hygienist 3 years ago, and I had trouble in school every single time with at least one teacher, except for dental assisting. That was amazing, actually. But so I totally understand, and I'm a very positive person naturally. So it takes a lot to bring me down. But when I have a teacher that's trying to fail me on everything, that makes me annoyed, considering I got very, very high marks, you know, so I totally understand. I can't say that enough. So I hope this helps. Sorry for the unprofessional video. But for those of you out there who are going through the same thing, you probably think, oh, finally, somebody's honest with me. So I hope this helped in some way, shape, or form. If you guys ever need anything, let me know, and I will see you guys in the next one.